Thank you, Chad. I appreciate the kind words. And Terry, I'm going to agree with you more when we talk about the heroes in this room. Ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed a pleasure to be here with you today at this Real Services celebration, a celebration of so many people who give so much of their time freely to try and help other people. For me, when I come back to South Bend, Indiana, and more specifically the University of Notre Dame, it's always a sense of feeling to come home, coming home to a place I spent the four formidable years of my life learning, trying to grow up as a collegiate, trying to understand what the significance of life is. And it's interesting, every time I come here to this area, to Northern Indiana, there's a peace and a calm. You're a different group of people than I travel and see around the United States of America. Everybody's in a hurry to do something that they want to get done. But yet you're in a hurry to try and help someone else. You provide a service that only caregivers can give, an unselfishness that rivals no one. You know, it's interesting to me, I think it's important to understand always when someone has an opportunity to speak to you, you ought to understand who they are a little bit. I know there's a bio in the program that explains who I am, but there's some things about me that I would like to share so that you have a little bit better understanding of who I am. First is I'm really not Joe Theismann. Appreciate the introduction though, Chad, but I'm actually Joe Theismann from South River, New Jersey. Now, this is a story that's been circulated. It's really a part of Notre Dame lore, and I want to qualify it for you today. See, back in 1970, when I was a senior at the University of Notre Dame, our sports information director and my dear friend Roger Baldessari called me in the office. He said, Joe, how do you pronounce your last name? I said, it's Theismann. He said, no, it's not. It's actually Theismann. I said, no, it's not. It's actually Theismann. He said, no, Joe, it's Theismann. I said, well, give me the phone. I picked up the phone and called my dad back home in New Jersey. And any time I ever had a question from my father, he'd always say, fire away, Joey. So I got my dad on the phone and I said, I've got a question for you. He said, fire away, Joey. I said, Dad, tell me, how do you pronounce our last name? Dead silence on the phone. About 30 seconds went by, my dad came on, he says, son, you really do have a problem, don't you? You're a senior in college, you don't know who you are. Now, what have you been doing for the last 3 years? I said, Dad, that's it. Please just tell me, how do you pronounce your last name? I'll explain it later. He said it was Theismann, I hung the phone up. I turned to Mr. Valdeseri, I said, Roger, look, my last name is Theismann. I know, I just got home with my dad. He said, Joe, I want to tell you something. There's a trophy out there called the Heisman Trophy. Best college football in the country gets that trophy, but we're not just going to count on your athletic ability nor the reputation of the University of Notre Dame to give you a chance to win that trophy. But we think by just simply changing the pronunciation of your last name from Theismann to Theismann to Ryan with Heisman, we get you that trophy.